Hello guys, welcome to Numerical Point, and this is a new initiative that is concept through numericals. We are solving numericals and understanding the concepts. This is OQD number 9, and we are currently dealing with the subject of fluid mechanics, and we have over with the fluid properties. Now it's time for fluid statics. Now from today onwards we are going to start fluid statics, and topic is fluid pressure. Okay, in this segment we will discuss about types of pressure, units of pressure, and in another question we will discuss about the pressure measurement and another things. Okay, for this video we will discuss about types and units of pressure. For this is question number 1, the level of the question will remain easy. So let's get started. Before we start, just hit the subscribe button, press the bell icon to never miss any update. Let's rock it. So guys, this is our question for today. Okay, but before we read the question, let's first understand the classification of pressure. Okay, classification of pressure. So now let's go to understand the classification of pressure. Okay guys. From the first I want to say that pressure is not varying. Okay, pressure it means that at a place, at a single place, there are no types of pressure. Okay, pressure is constant at a place, but the thing is there are many types to say. Okay, what is the pressure? Okay, there are many ways that way you can denote the pressure at a point. So in that fashion the types is classified. It is not like at a single press, at a single point there are three types of pressure. Not like that. Okay, pressure is invariant thing. Pressure can vary in many values at a single point, at a single type. Okay, the pressure is absolute, but the thing is there are many ways to denote that pressure. Okay, so in that fashion we are going to read the types of pressure. Okay, the first and foremost thing is our zero pressure. Okay, zero pressure, which is called absolute vacuum. Okay, absolute vacuum. So let's suppose this line, okay, is for our reference, that it is zero pressure line. Okay, zero pressure line. Zero pressure line means the pressure here is completely zero. Okay, there is no pressure, and this can be achieved only when there is no molecule, because molecules only exert pressure. Okay, this is due to the collision of the molecules on the wall, the pressure is exerted. But when there is no molecule at all, then there is no collision with the wall, so there is zero pressure line. It is practically unachievable, but this is a theoretical concept that this is zero pressure line. Okay, absolutely zero pressure, no pressure is there. Then this could be our first reference. Okay, this could be our first reference. If you will measure the pressure with respect to this pressure. Okay, anything in this universe which is measurable is measured with respect to one quantity. Okay, one fixed quantity. So if you measure the pressure with respect to this pressure, okay, this pressure, then this is a way of representation of pressure. Then what is the another way? The another way is the measuring the pressure with respect to our atmosphere. Okay, okay guys, so let's suppose this is our atmospheric pressure line. So this value is fixed. Okay, this value is fixed, this value don't gonna change, and this atmospheric pressure is measured from the zero pressure line. Okay, so from where this atmospheric pressure comes? Actually the air above us, the entire atmosphere exerts some pressure on us. Okay, on anybody on this earth, the entire atmosphere exerts some pressure on anybody on the earth, and that is called as atmospheric pressure. Okay, and if these are two reference, okay, this is first reference, this is second reference. If we'll measure the pressure विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू एटमोस्फेरिक प्रेशर, ओके, विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू एटमोस्फेरिक प्रेशर देन दैट विल बी कॉल्ड योर गेज प्रेशर. एंड इफ यू विल, हियर आई एम राइटिंग, इफ यू विल मेजर द प्रेशर विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू एटमोस्फेरिक प्रेशर देन इट विल बी योर गेज प्रेशर, ओके. एंड इफ यू विल मेजर विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू जीरो प्रेशर लाइन, ओके, जीरो प्रेशर लाइन व्हिच इज ऑल्सो नोन एज एब्सोल्यूट वैक्यूम, ओके, देर इज नो मॉलिक्यूल एट ऑल, एब्सोल्यूटली जीरो मॉलिक्यूल, एब्सोल्यूटली वैक्यूम, एब्सोल्यूट वैक्यूम. इफ यू मेजर योर प्रेशर विथ रेस्पेक्ट टू एब्सोल्यूट वैक्यूम देन दैट इज कॉल्ड योर एब्सोल्यूट प्रेशर, ओके. दीज आर द मेन टाइप्स ऑफ रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ प्रेशर, ओके. आइदर यू कैन से दैट इन दिस प्लेस, इन दिस पर्टिकुलर प्लेस द ग्रॉस गॉज प्रेशर इज दिस, और यू कैन से द एब्सोल्यूट प्रेशर इज दिस, ओके. There are two ways to express the pressure at a point on a body or anything. Okay, that is gauge pressure or absolute pressure. If you'll say the pressure with respect to atmosphere, then that will be gauge pressure. If you'll say the pressure is with respect to the absolute vacuum, then that will be absolute pressure. Okay. Let's suppose this is a line, okay, this is a point. Then you have to measure the pressure at this point, okay. So what can you do? You have two options. Either you will measure the pressure from the with respect to the absolute vacuum, okay, and that will be called your P absolute. That is your absolute pressure at this point. What is the other option that you have? You can measure the pressure also from with respect to the atmosphere. Okay, you can measure the pressure with respect to also the atmosphere. Then that will be called your P gauge. Okay, which will be called P gauge. The pressure with respect to atmosphere is called P gauge. Then here I can write, as you can observe, that P absolute will be equal to this, P absolute will be equal to P atmosphere plus P gauge. Yes or no? Here I am giving you one formula that P absolute is equal to P atm plus P gauge. Okay. So there is another thing here. Okay, always the pressure, maybe it could be above the atmosphere or it could be below the atmosphere. Okay, here I am showing another line showing a pressure below the atmosphere. Okay, so what will happen here? Here the same thing. This will be your what, P absolute from the absolute vacuum, and this will be a gauge pressure. Okay, but here if you will see, if the upward is positive then this will be negative. So we can say the any pressure, okay, any pressure which is less than atmosphere, okay, any pressure which is less than atmosphere, then that is called negative gauge pressure. Very simple, no rocket science here, and that is also called vacuum. Okay, this is important, vacuum. Okay, negative gauge pressure is called vacuum, and the name, if the negative gauge pressure is equal to your absolute pressure, then that is called absolute vacuum. Okay. Very simple. So the formula remains the same. Okay, the formula is not going to change. So you just need to put the value of p gauge in negative. So that, okay, p gauge, if you will put the p gauge in negative, so it will, what will it happen? So p absolute will be p atm minus p gauge. Okay, this value you will get. So this is all the types of pressure. Okay, so what we have seen, I'm just summarizing the things. One is zero pressure line, other is atmospheric pressure, another is gauge pressure. Okay, so hope you have understood the things. Now let's see the units of pressure. Okay guys, in front of you have some units of pressure that are the, okay, the first and foremost thing, pressure is force by area. So that is, sorry, force by area. Okay, force by area, force is Newton and area is meter square. Okay, so 1 Newton per meter square is also known as Pascal, and 1 bar is equal to 10 to the power 5 Pascal. Okay, this is 1 bar, that is 10 to the power 5 Pascal, and 1 atmospheric pressure has a fixed value, that is 101.325 kilopascal. And one atmospheric pressure can also be written as 760 mm of Hg, and 1 mm of Hg is also known as 1 torr. So 760 mm of Hg will be 760 torr. One atmospheric pressure can also be written as 10.3 meter of water. So how we are going to write all these things, I will say it later, but here I want to mark one point, that is one atmospheric pressure is 101.325 kilopascal. Okay, as you can see, the earth is not flat and all the points on earth doesn't have same atmosphere above it. So this value 101.325 kilopascal atmospheric pressure is not fixed for all the points on earth. So for which it is fixed for on the ocean, because you know we have 5 oceans and all of them are interconnected. So we can the scientist has said that all the oceans are as interconnected, so they will maintain a constant level of water, so that the above them the atmospheric pressure will be constant. So this is above the atmospheric above the ocean. But if you will for example, if you will reach to a hill region, okay, this is sea, so this is your hill, so here the atmosphere is different, the atmospheric pressure is different, here the atmospheric pressure is different. So scientists have also defined a new term that is called local atmospheric pressure. Okay, local atmospheric pressure. Okay, atmospheric pressure. So in any calculation, you just need to put the local atmospheric pressure. Okay, so all the calculations will be done on the basis of local atmospheric pressure. If the local atmospheric pressure is not given in the question, then go with 1 atm, that is 101.325 kilopascal, the standard value. So now let's rush to our problem of the day. Okay guys, this is the question of the day. Let's read the question. The pressure gauges G1 and G2. Here I want to clear one thing. The gauge will measure the gauge pressure. Okay, gauge will measure the gauge pressure. The pressure gauges G1 and G2 installed on the system as shown in figure. Okay, this is G1 and this is G2. As shown in figure, the reading as PG1 equal to 5 bar and PG2 equal to 1 bar. The value of unknown pressure P. Okay, here the pressure is P. The value of unknown pressure P is dash, and take atmospheric pressure is 1.01 bar. Okay, so guys, okay, first let's understand the question. This is one container ओके एंड द गॉज प्रेशर इनसाइड इट इज जी वन एंड दिस कंटेनर ए लेट सपोज दिस ए इज केप्ट अंडर अनदर कंटेनर ओके दैट इज बी एंड द गेज प्रेशर ऑफ बी इज जी टू ओके सो वी नीड टू फाइंड आउट द एब्सोल्यूट प्रेशर ऑफ पी ए कंटेनर ए सो इन ऑर्डर टू फाइंड आउट द एब्सोल्यूट प्रेशर ऑफ ए वी नीड टू फाइंड आउट द लोकल एटमोस्फेरिक प्रेशर फॉर दिस जी वन ओके दिस गेज दैट इज द एटमोस्फेरिक प्रेशर ऑफ दिस बी ओके देन इन ऑर्डर टू फाइंड द एटमोस्फेरिक प्रेशर वी नीड टू फाइंड आउट द एटमोस्फेरिक प्रेशर वी नीड टू ओके वी नीड टू एड दिस गॉज प्रेशर विद दिस एटमोस्फेरिक प्रेशर वाई बिकॉज आउटसाइड द बी दिस इज एटमोस्फेरिक ओके एंड द एब्सोल्यूट प्रेशर ऑफ बी ओके एब्सोल्यूट प्रेशर ऑफ बी विल बी ओके पी एब्सोल्यूट बी will be okay in this container total container okay for example this region the absolute pressure will be what will be p atmospheric plus p gauge so p atmospheric is okay I'm writing p atmospheric plus p gauge so what is p atmospheric p atmospheric is for this room is air so air is the p atmospheric is 1.01 bar given in the question okay take atmospheric pressure is 1.01 bar and what will be gauge pressure will be pg2 because it is measuring the gauge pressure and the gauge pressure pg2 is given as 5 bar okay 5 sorry 1 bar 1 bar so pg2 is 1 bar so the absolute pressure of b will be 2.02 bar what do you mean by this this means this room a okay this room a will feel an absolute pressure of 2.02 bar okay so this absolute pressure will be local atmospheric pressure for this room A okay so the pressure of room A will be local atmospheric pressure plus this gauge pressure that is G1 so we can write here the absolute pressure of okay the absolute pressure for room A will be p atmospheric plus p gauge okay so p atmospheric for this is the absolute pressure of B that is 2.02 bar so we can write here is equal to p atmospheric for B okay this is for B this is 2.02 bar plus p gauge of B is G1 that is 5 bar so we can write here p gauge for B is 5 so the answer will be 7.02 bar so guys this is the answer for today's question so the pressure of gauges G1 G2 installed in the system is this the value of unknown pressure PH okay it is asking the absolute pressure and we have found out that is 7.02 bar hope you have enjoyed the video and for more such videos just hit the subscribe button and never miss any update thank you I really appreciate your time